Hello, my Kopi Kakis. I haven't seen you for 3 months and you're still looking gorgeous. Oh my God.
Yes, and I have my coffee here in respect for what you have called for, a coffee session.
Yes, you know, and thank you for agreeing to come on my virtual Kopi table. Okay, the reason why I call for this very, very, immediate meeting is because, you know, I had an issue that I've been pondering and pondering and pondering over. And you know, right, we usually talk it over, you know, on a coffee. But now that we can't have that, I can only have you on my virtual coffee table. So here you go. Okay, so all of you are entrepreneurs, you know. I just need to know this from you guys. Recently, we put out a job, you know, onto the Geeks platform. And we were hoping that, you know, people will be snatching the job up. But to our horror, you know, nobody from Singapore, you know, made any move. So our job was out there for a couple of days. I thought, huh, you know, is it because I pay too little? What is it? Then Lily says, no, I tell you what, we will go regional. So we shot the job out regionally, and within 10 minutes, I kid you not, I have like 20 responses. So, you know what? I need you to tell me something, Kopi Kakis. What is this all about? You know, are our Singaporeans too entitled? What? Not hungry for a job? What? I don't know.
Why are you surprised, Jermaine? I mean, I've been a user of gig economy platforms like, you know, the Upworks and the Fivers and all for a very long time. And it's never surprising to me, number one, in terms of who put up their hands for the jobs. And secondly, who are really competitive in pricing, but really excellent in their work. So I think there needs to be a realization that the market is not just for Singapore. The market of talent is global. So I think we need to wake up to the idea that we are but a pool amongst a much bigger pool. And I think there needs to be a realization for that.
Wow. Actually, I agree to what Cheryl said. Like, I think a lot of Singaporeans don't realize that competition is now global, especially with like all this digitization and all. So people don't see that you don't just compete with like local, like maybe your colleagues or like your counterparts, your classmates. People are coming in from overseas. And like, because competition is so great, actually, you need to really know that, hey, where do you really stand in the market?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, the surprising thing is when I put up this job, which I thought is very little budget already, and people are coming back proposal at even lesser budget, and they didn't do that job. I was like, wow. But I was very surprised that all from the States, from really the far part of the world, and the nearest are like people like India, Pandi, Nepal, even from Nepal, and trying to look for Singapore. I was like scrolling, and eventually the one that says Singapore are actually physically in Philippines.
Interesting. I think what you have brought up is also an indication of, say, cost of living, depending on where they are. And I think competence. If they are very competent, given the job that you are asking for, they might actually just spend very little time for their dollar value. It's worth it for them. So I think those are probably veterans in the gig economy where they manage a whole portfolio of projects. And it makes sense for them.
Yeah. You know what? Eventually, the one that took it on, right? You know, she used to work in Singapore. So she knows Singapore very well. And we were very surprised. She even has a Singapore bank account. See, I don't even need to transfer money out. Okay? You know? And then she holds a job.
International job.
She holds a job in the Philippines, you know? And she's doing our work. And honestly, it's a great job done, you know. So and then somewhere in the middle, right, we thought, hey, maybe we give Singaporeans a chance again, okay? So I told Lily, I say, hey, after the editing of the 5, right, let's bring it back to Singapore. And then we have a few people who talk to me and they literally very nicely tell us, don't waste our time. Oh no! You know, I mean, I was wondering, guys, please tell me. Yeah, do y'all really think that Singaporeans are really way too entitled? Or are they just blur? Are they just still in their Singaporean world, thinking that you know, the jobs are going to cascade down from the sky after this in the new normal. You know what I'm saying?
Actually, I think it could be a situation that they are not aware of all these different platforms. I mean, I really don't know. Maybe the younger ones do know of such platforms like Upwork, Fiverr. They don't mind taking the extra hassle, learning how to use it, or like going through that system. But I think majority might not. So it's still like the very traditional way of like, yeah, I want to find a job. If I don't find it on a career portal, I will go to some recruiter or any government aid kind of platform.
Yeah, I think it's also, well, if they are already in the gig economy, but not on platforms, then they're basically losing out on a whole actually free marketing for themselves, right? Oh. And if they feel that that $500 is not worth it, then I think it's, what do you think they're measuring as an opportunity cost? I think it, no, the sad thing is if we have to wait out until it's the very last moment, the water is boiling and you are that frog in that water, that is very sad. But I think
it's very scary
that gradually there has to be a realization, because corporate jobs are going to get far and between. But I think one of the key things that as a society we need to be more accepting is that freelancers is a proper job.
Yeah.
And that they should be recognized as an entrepreneur. Just like, I mean, in India and Philippines, if you're an entrepreneur, a solopreneur, you are, you know, they wear that with pride, you know, that I am one who have fought the war and I am actually bringing in business for other people. Whereas in Singapore, I think everybody's still waiting to get into a job. And if it was just in the meantime, in my job search, $500 may not be what I'm looking for, you know, kind of thing. So I think that the perspective of it, yeah. But I think it's going to be an eye-opening season.
I guess I understand where you're coming from. Like $500, just one meal in Hai Di Lao, and that's it already. After working so hard, right?
No, if you are in Philippines or in Indonesia, Bali, right? There's no Hai Di Lao.
Oh my God. Okay, just one very quick last question for the two of you. You know, I mean, do you use, because this is our first time, no, shooting our job, no. So I am so stunned. You know, you have been in the game far longer. Do you use mixture Singaporeans overseas or overseas? What?
Definitely from around the world. And I must say that dollar value and quality of work is actually excellent. But as a user, you need to hone your skills on project management and writing the scope of work. That's also learning on our part.
Wow.
So we do use some of these platforms.
Yeah.
Actually, what I learned, similar to what Cheryl mentioned, is making sure that you know what you are asking for, managing the person, and then clarifying the deliverables that you ultimately receive. And it is through a virtual platform also. So similarly, like what we are doing now through Zoom, like if there's anything we need to communicate, it's only through like this kind of platform.
Yeah, I know. Okay, I know you guys are very busy. It's just a very quick, you know, get together. Thank you so much for easing my mind. I really think that, oh my gosh, you know, Lily is out for what? You know what's happening? But it isn't. Okay, so I hope that for people who are listening in, it's a bit tongue-in-cheek, but it is a very serious situation, you know, that we could be facing here. So thank you very much for all your insight.
Thank you, and enjoy your coffee.
Yes, I will. Bye.
Bye-bye.